In the warm, shallow waters of the Pacific Ocean lives a squid with a lifelong symbiotic devotion, a vital relationship that begins the day they hatch, survival tied to one type of bacteria they catch. In this story, the Hawaiian bobtail squid is the host, and Vibrio fishieri is the guest with the most.
Poetic empiricist, together they match the moonlight, 2018.
Early Earth was uninhabitable for a billion years. At this stage, it resembled nothing of how it now appears. It lacked the vital components of living environments. The oceans had yet to form and the air was toxic and dense. Earth collided with space debris. A fragment became the moon. This space rock contained ice, and across the planet it was strewn. The Earth was molten, so a billion years to cool was a must. Slowly, the top layer would solidify into a crust. Cooling the Earth resulted in another important change. It became a water planet in this low temperature range. Accumulating liquid water upgraded Earth's status. In order to start life here, this was critically momentous.
Poetic Empiricist, Difference in Time, 2013.
The forgetting curve is the natural, steep degradation of knowledge over time, specifically for subjects you don't utilize. Consider how amazing it is that our brains can temporarily learn and store vast amounts of detailed information. If that information were maintained and reinforced, it would become more permanent. A bodybuilder wouldn't consider their past workouts a waste. The effort of the past equipped them to lift heavier weights in the present. Another thing learners should have in common with bodybuilders is the desire to be well-rounded. Developing just one group of muscles while neglecting the rest of the body would appear strange. Learning only one subject is equally undesirable. I truly believe that anyone can learn anything. This is what my business, Vintage Learners, is all about. For over a decade, I've lived this motto with hundreds of my adult students. Conversely, learned helplessness is a psychological phenomenon coined by Martin Seligman. In some instances, giving up and underachieving is a learned behavior reinforced by a combination of enabling and holding low expectations. It is true that there are subjects that will be easier to learn, and these differ from learner to learner. There are multiple types of intelligences that humans can possess. For this reason, a topic may seem more or less intuitive. Howard Gardner in the 1980s first theorized this concept. Dr. Gardner differentiated 8 separate intelligences: visual spatial, linguistic, musical, bodily kinesthetic, logical mathematic, natural, interpersonal, and intrapersonal. The other side of this concept would be that we all have subjects that we are challenged by. Fear of certain subjects, for example, math, is unfortunately very common and becomes valid when the fear creates a mental block. This mental block perpetuates and builds upon itself. As an adult educator, I've had many students with long-term learning phobias. It is possible within a supportive environment for a learner to overcome fear and take their power back. Despite my master's in earth space science, I ended up teaching chemistry and biology. In college, there were parts of my chemistry course that I struggled with. For example, stoichiometry. Once I finally figured out what I was reading or hearing, I had to put it in my own terms with examples and metaphors. When I started teaching chemistry to adults, I would offer these alternative explanations to my students. Later, I made those into videos for Vintage Learners. I know my adult students won't necessarily use chemistry in their day-to-day nursing responsibilities. They know this too. However, they appreciate the role chemistry plays in all aspects of their job, from the function of every cell in the human body to the medications they're administering. Learning is never a waste.